Thank you so much for stopping into my channel. Of course, I would love it so much if you would hit the subscribe button on your way out of here today. Today's video is a DIY, as you can see from the title. I'm going to show you how I made these very cheap, very cute, farmhouse style inspired wall decor for my kitchen. So if you are interested to see how I made these, please stay tuned. So first, you're going to need three 11 by 14 frames, three 8 by 10 frames. You're gonna need three packs of these paint mixing sticks from a home improvement store. And then you're gonna wanna print out whatever pictures you wanna use. I just found these ferns online for free and printed them at home. All right, so to get this started, of course your frames came from the Dollar Tree. I don't think I mentioned it. For your sticks, you see one side has numbers like a ruler. You wanna make sure you're using the other side so the numbers do not show. So you're on your 11 by 14 frame, you want to pop out the back of the frame and the glass because you're not going to need to use those, and you literally only want the frame of that picture frame. You're going to use 9 sticks per frame, so you just want to line these up even enough to your liking. Once you have them the way you would like it, I just use my hot glue gun to secure these in place. You can also paint these sticks if you would like to. The natural wood color is fine for me to go with my decor, but if you wanted to paint these black, white, green, orange, purple, whatever you want to match your decor, you can definitely paint that with just some regular old, you know, craft or wood paint. All right, once that's complete, I wanna take my 8x10 frame. All I did was line it up on the paper of the ferns that I printed out, traced it to make it become an 8x10 instead of the standard paper size, 8.5x11. So I just traced that out and then just used my scissors to cut off the excess paper. Once that's been removed, you want to pop it back in the frame and pop off the stand from the frame because you want it to lay flat on the board. Once you've done that, you're ready to secure your 8x10 frame to your sticks. You can use command strips if you would like. If you say, for instance, you want to switch out the picture that's in there, I would recommend using the command strip so that you can take it off and be able to switch out the pictures as you would like, say for different seasons or different holidays. I just decided just to use my hot glue gun and secure it here because I change my mind quite often. So these may be, you know, just up for now, and then I've changed my decor quite frequently. So I have these up for now. You just want to secure it with some hot glue gun. I just put some on the corners and then also a little bit right in between those on the top and on the sides. Guys, also be very careful with these frames. They are from the Dollar Tree. So you want to be gentle with making sure you're not applying too much pressure or being too rough because they can break fairly easily. But that is it. Once you have secured your frame to the frame in your boards, either using your hot glue gun or command strips, you are literally done, and you just recreate this for my project 3 times. If you want to do 2 of them, 4 of them, you just recreate as many as you need to cover whatever piece of wall you're doing in your house. But that is it. It is so simple. So to finish off my decor, I actually added these little Mason Light Canada jars. I don't know what they're called, but I'll link them below. I bought them from Amazon, and I just anchored those on either side of the frames, and I did not like the flowers that came with them, so I put some fake flowers I already had at home in there, and I also painted that backing black because it did not come black. And that is the finished project, guys. So if you have enjoyed this video, please comment below and give me a thumbs up, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.